I think the music on this movie will be very innocent, very melodic, very tonal, beautiful. I think the music will capture the kind of Eastern European tone in Victor's personality and character. So there'll be some ethnic sounds to underscore Victor's story, and some very sweet, innocent American sounds to underline the essence of who Amelia is, and then another beautiful theme that brings both characters together.
I like this film very much, The Terminal, you know. It's a love story, of course, in a way. But I also see this thing as a kind of an Ellis Island poem, if you like. And so musically, you know, it's an opportunity to create music for Victor that has an ethnic texture.
Mr. Thurman, there is a man walking around the terminal in a bathrobe.
I know, sir. You put him there.
And I have featured a clarinet, which is in the idiom of so many groups of Eastern Europe and the southeast part of Europe, but also the cimbalon, which is an instrument, I think, if I'm not mistaken, indigenous to Hungary. And it's played with hammers, and it will be part of the orchestral texture to suggest latitude and culture and so on, and also the very subtle use of an accordion with this also in a concert orchestra setting. So it's a lovely piece and presented nice opportunities for musical score.
Welcome to Berkeley. May I take your
Let's do Killer Joe. It worked all right last night, so we'll try. Oh, just, yes.
You are Benny Golson.
Yeah, yes, I am,
yeah. Benny Golson, I am Victor Navorsky. I am from Krakowia.
I like the jazz sequence, of course, at the end very much. I love this whole idea. The photograph of the jazz greats is, at least in my part of the culture, a very well-known photograph. The general broad public will probably not know what it is, and most of them won't know who are these people in the photograph. But I've known that photograph for decades. But there are people in there, like Miff Mohl, for example, who's one of the signatories on the little tickets that he has. Miff Mohl was a famous trombonist in the 1920s, and I will tell you, probably the first time I've ever said this publicly, that for many years I had his trombone. It was given to my father from that man, and it was given to me as a youngster when I was studying that instrument. It's a picture that includes household names in the jazz world, as well as people that are more esoteric and a little less well-known, including Benny Golson.
I promise I will go to New York, find Benny Golson, give him right name to Putinkin.
And you've been living here all this time so you could do this for your father.
Maybe I think he'd do it for me.
Story-wise, that a man would come from Eastern Europe with a little can of autographs, it's a fantastic idea. You know, it's a very nice point about the jazz being a subplot of the film. You know, in a poetic sense, I guess you could say the reason that Victor is here, to have the autograph of Benny Golson, who was a great jazz musician. And the only music that's sort of somewhat related to that idiom is the music that I've written for Amelia, who in my mind is so American.
In English, Victor Navorsky.
In English, Amelia Warren.
Amelia Warren?
Yeah.
Nice to meet you.
You too.
There is something that I and Stephen would call a love theme, and that is the theme that springs off in my mind Amelia in the texture of what it is. This is a very kind of American-sounding piece, in contrast to Victor's music. And that theme is introduced in that fountain scene. becomes very much of a love scene when we have the camera pull back from the fountain and the two shot of the two people coming together in that shot. It acts as a love theme as they exchange looks at the airport, very poignant and very sweet. It's a lovely piece, very gratifying thing to have worked on.